That's about to change. Last year, I made a resolution that I would make myself the ultimate machine.
You and your little friend want some sandwiches?
I'm 42, Mom! Leave me alone!
Jeffrey, it's chilly out there!
I'm wearing my karate gi! I have on my gi. As I was saying, I made a resolution that I would make myself the ultimate machine in body, mind, and soul. And to prove that I've accomplished my resolution, I'm going to karate chop these bricks.
Okay. I love a new start. Nope, that's a lie. I hate even starting my car. But you know what? I believe in change. Oh, that's another lie. Changing my underwear scares the heebie-jeebies out of me. Bottom line on change? Change is for the ashtray. Not for me.
I love redos. I mean, my life is pretty much one big mulligan, you know? And I like lists, but I'm not really good at them. Or at least I wasn't, but now there's an app for that. Yeah, it's so great. You can put in your resolutions. It has reminders. It breaks it down into categories like physical, spiritual, emotional, which I won't need. But let's just get to it.
Is there a problem?
No, you have to enter a lot of information. I should have read the review on it. But, you know what? Never mind. Let's get started on the new me.
Oh, really? Because that sounds like Angry Birds.
Hey, Phineas and Ferb, you're probably asking yourself, what are we going to do today? Well, I can tell you what you're going to do today. You're going to live your best life yet. Hello, my name is Dan D. Lewis, part-time barista, part-time PE coach at Tisdale Community College, and full-time life coach. You know what I find disheartening? I find it disheartening when people, they give up on themselves. Why do they do that, you ask? Well, I can tell you. I call them the three Ps. They don't persevere, they procrastinate, and they forget their purpose, which means they miss the field goal. Listen up, cupcake. Did a young Kirk Cameron give up on himself during all those growing pains? I think not. Today, that man is fireproof. No one left him behind.
What are you doing? No, hey, no, this is mine. I'm gonna do this. Yes, I am. Yes, this is my resolution.
Guys, hey, we're running out of time.
What? Oh gosh. Oh, we're out of time. Oh, look at there. Look what you did, resolution ruiner. Maybe next year.
Mom, make me a sandwich!
No!
Well, good morning. Welcome to Open Arms. Anybody here make some resolutions? Not one hand did I see go up. Oh, I saw one. Make a list of things that I'm not so sure I'll follow through on, right? Isn't that what it tends to be? Yeah, well, might we resolve to follow Jesus in 2020? That'll do for me. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you for wanting us to be together in your presence today. Pour out your Holy Spirit as you determine, Lord, as you desire. Draw us to yourself, Lord. Continue to transform our lives and make us to be like Jesus. For we pray in his matchless name. Amen.
Blood and righteousness. not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. Christ the Lord, cornerstone, weak made strong in the same.
I invite you to take hold of that program you received this morning, please. Reach inside and take the connection card, and then grab one of those pens you find in front of you. We want to take the next couple of moments to fill these out together. And then please keep the card nearby. We're going to come back to it in a few moments as we're all going to be encouraged to take at least one next step in our spiritual journeys. And perhaps some of the next steps outlined on the back of the card make sense for you and for me today. So let's take the next couple moments to fill these out, please.
A song that has nothing to do with anything other than we just love to play it.
Thank you.
In your program, you also found an envelope there. If you'd like to make a financial donation to support God's work through Open Arms, I invite you to use the envelope, and please put your name on it, if you will. Only a few announcements for today that are in the folder there. Just highlight the fact, Tuesday night, 6:15, the men's only group is kicking off 2020. For the first time, we'll be meeting this coming Tuesday. So guys, check it out. See if it might be something the Lord can use in all of our lives to help us to walk with him. Let's stand together then as we sing, please.
Days.
I invite you to be seated. Lord, we are always in need of your grace. Without your loving kindness, your forgiveness, without your desire to be in a relationship with us, we would all be lost. And indeed we are, apart from Christ Jesus. We are all lost. Might we be found in him, O Lord, not because of who we are or what we could do to earn our way back into your presence or gain your favor, but because of your graciousness. You have done everything for us already in Christ Jesus to forgive us and restore us into that relationship with you. And it's all by grace, your unmerited favor that you pour into our lives. Indeed, your Bible teaches us, Lord, that You are at work in our lives by your Holy Spirit long before we ever give one thought about you. Indeed, you have poured out your Holy Spirit upon all persons in every place, in every generation, ever since Jesus returned to heaven, so that all persons might be drawn to you. Father, help us so that we will not resist the Holy Spirit, but that we would allow ourselves to be drawn to you and to discover your grace. Lord, help us. In the beginning of a new year, new decade, new whatever, help us. Many of us have things that are swirling around in our lives where we once again need your grace. We need your help. We need your wisdom. We need your provision. We need you to show up in ways that once again will help us to believe that you are the loving Father who has given all for us. Lord, we probably have preconceived ideas of what you should do for us, but save us from ourselves and do what is best for each and every one of us. Accomplish your purposes in and through our lives, and then use us in the everyday things of life to nudge others into your presence so that they too might experience your grace, your great grace that you have for all of us. Help us to live a lifestyle of grace. For we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Hear the voice of love that's calling. There's a chair that waits for you, and a friend who understands everything you're going through. You keep standing at a distance in the shadows of your shame, but there's a light of hope that's shining. Won't you come and take your place?
Savior, and he calls.
It's nothing he ain't seen before. For all your sin, all your sorrow and your sadness, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table. For all your sin, all your sorrow and your sadness, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table.
Once again, I invite you to take hold of that program. We don't have any fill-in-the-blanks for today. Oh, missing out on them, huh? Got a little different way to worship today. Focusing on the sacrifice that Christ made for us on the cross of Calvary by sharing in the elements of the Lord's Supper, that last meal that Jesus shared with his disciples so long ago before he was arrested and then beaten and fake trials and all that stuff, and then hung on a cross to die in our place so we might be forgiven. And that also opens us up to receiving the healing power of God through his Holy Spirit, that Jesus is our healer. And we're going to have the opportunity over here with these chairs to gather around anyone who would like to be prayed for and to be anointed with oil, as it says in God's Bible. We're going to read that in a few moments. And see how God wants to work in our lives. Remind us of the grace he has for us and the way he wants to work in our lives and that he's for us and so forth. So it's a good time to be together in this place. We start first with a passage of Scripture from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. You can follow along in your program if you'd like to. And it reads that on the night when the Lord Jesus was sold to his enemies, he took bread. He thanked God for it. Then he broke it and said, "Take this bread and eat it. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this so that you will remember me." We read in the Scriptures that in the same manner, after the supper, Jesus took the cup. He said, "This cup is the new agreement made by my blood. Every time you drink from this cup, do it to remember me." We're reminded in God's Bible how there is forgiveness and cleansing from any and all sin because of Jesus and what he has done for us. Now, you see in your program a series of questions that are underneath the scripture reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. I encourage you, as we have some music playing in a moment, to reflect on these questions and consider answering them in the quietness of your heart and mind, obviously. Maybe even take a look at the next steps on the connection card, because maybe the answer to the one of these questions is the next step that God wants you to take in your spiritual journey. So with that in mind, let's hear Redeemed by Big Daddy Weave. If you remember from the Advent season, the Christmas season, one of the R's for our candle was redeemed, right? Jesus is our Redeemer. We've been bought back. We've been freed from sin. He has brought us back into the presence of the Heavenly Father. He's just waiting for us to say yes. So let's say yes to Him, maybe for the first time today, or maybe for the umpteenth time today, so that we would experience the loving kindness of God, His grace, in new ways and in fresh ways. We switch gears just slightly. But as I already mentioned, any healing that comes from the hand of our gracious Father is because of who Jesus is and what Jesus has done for us by His sacrificial death. So we read this from James chapter 5, verses 13 through 16. Is anyone among you in trouble? Let them pray. Is anyone happy? Let them sing songs of praise. Is anyone among you sick? Let them call the elders of the church to pray over them and anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer offered in faith will make the sick well. The Lord will raise them up. If they have sinned, they will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective. Before we see the video, Even If by Mercy Me, I just want to highlight the last question that you see underneath that reading from James chapter 5. Will I ask Jesus to help me start an accountability relationship with at least two other persons of my gender? If we want to really move forward in our spiritual lives, kind of fast track it, if you will, we need to be in accountable relationships with other people who will tell us when we're straying and commend us when we're following Christ in obedience. I've been a part of a group for a lot of years, two other guys. It's been very helpful in my walk with Christ Jesus. I know of others who are in a small group of three or four, and they meet on a regular basis, and they listen to one another, and they pray for one another, and they're there to support one another. Maybe you'd like to be a part of a group like that. Maybe there'll be a next step you can put on your connection card, and I can help maybe put some things together. So that we can have some of these accountable relationships. But with that in mind, let's listen to this next video. Our hope, my friends, is in the Lord Jesus. Yes, he can heal us in an instant if he chooses, but even if he doesn't, he still loves us. He's still working what's best for us, even as we struggle, perhaps to understand. Grab your connection card, if you would, please, because maybe there's that next step that we need to take in our spiritual journey based on what we've been doing for worship today. Maybe you want to give consideration to the truths that are contained here from 1 Corinthians chapter 11 or James chapter 5. You notice the page numbers in the program corresponding to the Bibles that we use here. Feel free to grab one of those Bibles so you can easily find these truths, or take a Bible if you know one who would benefit from having a Bible. Maybe today is the day to accept Jesus' forgiving love for the very first time and to begin to follow him, begin the journey with Jesus. Maybe we've kind of become like a prodigal, and it's time to come back to the Lord and rejoin the journey with him. No better time than right here and right now to make that commitment. I want to take the step to let Christ's mercy continue to shape the way I live every day. I always ask that you'll pray for me. And I tell you, I'll be praying for you this coming week with the next steps and other requests that you'll have in your connection cards. And our prayer team will pray confidentially for all of us. And maybe this is a step you want to take as well. I also want to ask Jesus to bring healing and wholeness into my life. I know he's not done rebuilding my life, the broken places that are there, and how he wants to reshape who I am. Maybe we want to take the step as well to share the good news about Jesus with someone else. And once again, I left a blank line there. If you'd like to jot down somebody's name or nickname or initials, we can be praying for one another as we share our story of Jesus and how he's at work in our life with others. And I'm also planning to return next Sunday for worship as we look at a series, a 2020 vision. How's God going to be at work? How are we going to be looking for Jesus in the new year? So I invite you to join with us for next week. And then there's a blank line there. If the Lord has given you a special step he wants you to take, I invite you to use that line and jot some things down. Well, ready to share in the Lord's Supper and to pray for one another. So here's what we're going to do. When you're ready, we're going to come down this aisle over here. Come across the front. If you have financial gifts to give to support God's work through Open Arms or your connection card, I invite you to leave it in the basket here. But you don't have to put anything in this basket in order to participate in the Lord's Supper or in our prayer time together. But I invite you to put something in that basket there and then come across the front here. I better get in the right place. Tear off a piece of bread. Dip it in the cup, and then eat with thanksgiving for what Jesus has done in your life and how you are greatly loved. Then if you would like to be prayed for, I've asked the prayer team and Pastor Herb to assist this morning. We invite you to come and wait here. Probably if there's a few people, just sit here. Wait your turn. If you would like to have the women of the prayer team to pray with you as a woman, we just say, make that request known. If you're a guy and you want just me and Pastor Herb to pray with you as guys, we invite you to just let us know, and we'll anoint you with oil in the name of Jesus for healing and wholeness. I guess that's the instruction. But you, my friends, are greatly loved, without a doubt. Without a doubt. And I invite you to come to the table of the Lord and do a time of special prayer in the name of Christ Jesus. Yeah, go ahead.
I want everybody to be alert to something. There's nothing spooky about what we're doing.
No.
Not at all. I pray to God, and I wish we do this every week, that people would come forth expressing their concerns and their burdens on their own behalf, struggles that they're having. The James passage says that to confess your sins to one another. I don't know that we honestly ever deal with the sin issue in our lives. And there's been a number of things written over the years on the subject. Whatever became sin, it's one when John and I were in college. It still is so vital and active today. There's no help unless we seek it. I'm reminded of so many illustrations that I've seen over the years. But you've got a tragic, tragic illness that's going to take your life. And I'm holding the capsule right here in my hand. And I'll peel it for you. This is an illustration. It's in fact. All you have to do is come and take it. It's not going to cost you anything. Except maybe some humiliation. Some humbleness. Stand up and say, I need help. We all need.
Amen.
Trust me. I've been on the rock 65 years. I've walked with Jesus a long time now. I still need help each and every day to be who it is that he wants me to be. And so I would encourage you, don't wait until John opens the, kicks the door down and sets the chairs up and offers communion. If you need prayer at any point in time during the course of the week, give us a call.
Amen.
After any service, during any service, telling you you need prayer, step up. There's no limit to it. It's not just special times when this power is available to us. And it's not our power. It's not anybody in the room's power. It's Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit, the blessed and anointed Holy Spirit of God, who is walking and breathing and living among us, even at this very moment. And I thank you. I thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you. Let's stand together, please. I want you to remember that Jesus loves you. Remember that Jesus likes you. Remember that Jesus wants you. And that Jesus wants to hang out with you. So let him do it this week. And let's live life in the very presence of God. Thank you very much for choosing to worship here today.